Hello everyone. Today I'm going to show you my beautiful plumbago plant. This is called blue plumbago. Okay, it is also known as Cape plumbago or sky flower. It is from South Africa. Let me show you a close-up. Look at the flower, how it looks like. See this beautiful white blue. Look at the green, fresh leaves. I love this plant because bluish white is my favorite color, and this flower is actually bluish white color, as you can see here, little bit of blue and white. It's so beautiful. This flower, this particular plant blooms flowers all year round. So yeah, so you can have flowers all year round. It is beautiful like this. A lot of new growths here, new flower buds here, as you can see here. So it's going to make a lot of new flowers, right? So this is the plant. Now this is a very easy to care plant. Anyone beginning in gardening or want to start with gardening can actually take this plant as well, right? This is a very good beginner plant and very easy to grow as well, right? Look at this. You can grow this plant in container or in any pots, or also having hanging baskets, right? It's a very beautiful plant. See, let me show you close up again. Now the reason you see this flower so healthy and fresh like this, because this is actually a flower that loves sunlight. I've been keeping this plant outdoor under direct sunlight, so it really enjoys sunlight. I give it a lot of water, it enjoys plenty of water, right? I planted it in a very well draining potting mix. See, also another thing, this is actually but this plant is not for those impatient, because it needs a lot of pruning. For example, I show you an example. You see here, this is the dried flower, right? The flower already dried off. So every time the flower dries off, it will have dry edges like this. So you need to keep pruning. Imagine the lot of flowers, okay, when they dry, you'll have these dry sections like this, right? So if you don't prune it, it will make the plant look ugly or not not cared for. So you need to do a lot of pruning. So you need to have a lot of patience to have this plant. But if you do have, yeah, then this is a good plant for you, right? Like this one here, see, needs to be cut, need to be pruned. See, it's a very beautiful plant. Show you a close up some more. See, now if you plant this plant directly in the ground without any pot or container, it can grow up to at least 10 to 11 feet. Okay, in that case you don't need to prune, you can just let it grow wild, and you can have lots of beautiful flower like this surrounding it. Okay, and it will look nice too. Okay, this one I'm growing in a pot, so that's why the size is a bit small. This is about half less than a half meter tall. See, now how to propagate this plant. This is very easy. As I mentioned, this is a very easy to take care plant, right? Very easy to propagate. All you need to do, just cut the plant, okay, 5 inches like this. See, I show you, 5 inches like this, or like this. Just cut off here, okay, about 5 inch, and then plug them in directly into cocopit, and then just leave it under shade for about 3 weeks. You can see after 3 weeks you can see root, but you need to water them every day so that the root will grow. After 3 weeks to 4 weeks, you can actually transfer to a smaller pot. I'll show you an example. You see this one in a smaller pot. This is 6 weeks old. Okay, I just plug, like I said just now, 5 inch softwood, right, and then plug it straight into a cocopit, and then after 3 weeks it actually rooted. Then I transfer it to a small pot like this. Okay, this is 6 weeks old. So yeah, eventually it will grow bigger. I need to repot this to a bigger pot. I have two here. Okay. There's another one here. You see, even at this size, right, after about 6 weeks, right, it already started to flower. The reason it flowers faster because when I cut the softwood for plant growing the root, I cut together with the buds like this. So it doesn't matter whether it has a bud or not. The flower bud, you can just cut and then transfer directly to cocopeat and grow it, right? So it works well. So there you go. Now one more thing I want to share. I'm not sure about this, but I did not do any research on this, but I read that this plant is toxic to all part of this plant is toxic for humans, right? So just take note of that. Make sure there's no kids around in the house, you know, accidentally eat or bite any of these particular parts of the plants, right? Now my rule of thumb is very easy. Okay, anything that we know is ornamental plants, like, you know, we grow for indoor or house as ornamental plants, right, it's not best to treat it as poisonous. Okay, unless it is proven, like, you know, we eat it like vegetables. If we don't know and we are not sure, treat all plants toxic for human and kids, right? And for kids especially, better to train them that all ornamental plants to be treated as poisonous. Train them from young age itself, right? So they won't be, like, you know, simply like biting or putting things in their mouth, you know, putting any plants in their mouth, right? So this is very important for safety. Okay, see. Now for the fertilizer, what I use rabbit manure. I have few rabbits at the back of my home, so I just use their manure and also the chicken manure. So I use organic fertilizer. This plant, I don't use any chemical fertilizer, so they just grow well with the rabbit manure. So, but for flowering, it needs a lot of potassium. So for potassium, I use ground coffee grounds, right, every once a month. So that encourages it to flower more like this, right? So yeah, you can use that as well, right? So make sure it gets sufficient potassium monthly, and you can use organic fertilizers like rabbit manure, as I mentioned just now. Okay, another thing about this plant, after a few years growing in the same pot, it is best to repot it into a bigger pot to encourage a wider root growth, because if you don't change the pot, what will happen is that it will eventually start not to flower a lot, right? So to encourage more flowering, it's better to repot it every now and then, okay, 1 year or two, so, right? See, now one more thing also I want to share. I've never encountered any pest issue with this plant. I don't know why no pest is actually biting this plant, all right? Maybe it could be because too toxic or what, I'm not sure. So anyway, that's one thing I want to. So I've never had any pest problem with this plant. So yeah, that's a good part about this plant, all right? So there you go, folks. This is a very easy to take care plant. So this is what I wanted to share with you all today. I hope you like this plant, all right? If you love this plant, get one also, because this flowers all year round. By the way, these tips I'm giving is based on my growing experience in tropical country, all right? So that's one thing you need to take note. In different countries with different climates or temperature or weather, like, you know, in Europe or US, where you experience multiple seasons, like winter for example, maybe this will have a dormancy period. So you need to check with growers in your region, okay, how this works out, all right? So that's one thing you need to take note, okay? Otherwise, everything else that I share is based on my experience, all right? So you can follow that, okay? So that's all for now. Thank you so much. Have a nice day. Bye.